the most important thing was that evening came and we were together. The family was together. And that was until July 23, when they announced that they're going, when we heard, they didn't announce it, no, they, we heard that they're going to liquidate.
And this is 1943.
July 43. And we all, by then, they had in that building a little bunker where all of us, not my father, because he was at work. My sister happened to be home, both sisters, and my mother and I. But my father was taken to a different, for a different job. And we went, all of us from that building, went into that bunker, hiding. And they went, and we were sitting there waiting, hoping not to be found out. But we heard boots over the, our heads, the heavy boots, and we knew that it's time is up. And they started yelling, opened that cover, and they started screaming and yelling, Juden heraus, Juden heraus. And people didn't know what to do, and they started, no choice, they started crawling out, walking out of that. And they started, whoever was slow, slow down, so they were shooting down, shooting down.
How many and people were hiding with you at that point?
We would say about 20, maybe 15, some of people that were at work there in the laundry and that lived in the place. Not more than that, I don't think. And they started shooting into that bunker. My sister kept saying, don't you, don't move, don't move. But my mother was going. The older sister went already. Clara must have been, that I found out later, she was shot. When they were shooting down, she was shot in the leg. And she just was going out and yelled at me that nobody's there, you don't, just don't move. And whatever clothes people, as they were crawling out, they threw off their jackets or sweaters or whatever they had on. She threw all that on top of me, covered me up, and she crawled out. I don't know, then it quieted down. I don't know how long it took, day or two, and I was there, and then afraid to go out.
You were the only one left in there,
the only one
covered
left
up
in
by
that,
the clothes.
That, with that clothes, because she just threw all the clothes, covered me up. And after a day or two, can't recall, I don't know what, how long it took, I heard Jewish voices. And that's when I made a sound.
But what was going on in your mind during that day or two? First of all, how were you staying alive?
A day, it must have been a day and a night, because that was during the day. The following day, they decided to come, apparently, and clean up the mess, clean the rest of it. Because I heard the Jewish voices, so I came out, I made a noise, and they pulled me out from there. And like you say, how did I survive? Then they started feeding me with a tablespoon of water, not starting with it, just to bring me back to life, and told me, and I saw the bed where my sister crawled out. She sat down that she was killed right there. But she couldn't walk, she was shot, she was wounded, so they killed her right on the spot. And they were cleaning up, and they said, this is it, we're cleaning up the camp for good. And that's when my father showed up. He and other, the people that were working, that were still survived, were taken to work to clean up that camp. And my father, we were sticking together, and he couldn't, he was just broken, so heartbroken, but broken up completely with his wife and the two daughters he lost, that he couldn't
survive. Well,
you
didn't know what had happened to your mother and older sister.
They were taken away. We didn't know what happened. We found out later.
But you only knew at that point that
they were not here, that
they
were taken
Clara.
Away. That my father, my sisters, and my older sister was already engaged, so she, I think the boyfriend was with, walked out with her. They all walked out. My mother was even in a rope, I think it was that early in the morning. They walked away, and